Hi there, I'm Christopher Harrison, Senior Program Manager, Microsoft Cloud and AI. Let's take a look at how dates work inside of JavaScript. Now, I don't need to or mean to necessarily get like all deep and philosophical, but you know, time is just a construct. Or at the very least, in JavaScript terms, time is an object. So let's take a look at this object and see how we can utilize it to manipulate time. Well, at least in our code, not necessarily in the real world yet. All right, so all of my bad jokes aside, working with dates and times in JavaScript centers around one object, and that is the date object. This date object is going to actually contain both the date and the time. Now, one thing that I want to highlight here is the fact that internally, time is actually stored as the number of milliseconds since January 1st in 1970. And this will actually become a little bit of a thing later on, but I just always like to call that out right up front. Now, to create a brand new date object, we simply say const now equals new date. And that will give us the date and time for right now. Well, what happens if I need to program something where I'm going to be working with a particular date and I need to make sure that I'm able to go ahead and set that? Well, there's actually a few different constructors that are available to us with date. One of them will give us the ability to specify the year, the month, the day. So this would be 2015, the 12th day, and then the fourth month. That one big thing to keep in mind about the way that months are specified on the object is they start with zero. So zero would be January, one would be February, two March, and then three would actually be April. So this would be April 12th. 2015, and then the time would be 6 a.m., 24-hour clock, 25 minutes, and 58 seconds. If all we want to do is specify the year, the month, and the day, then we can do that. And this would be 1995, August, because again, remember, starts with zero, and then the 24th. Now, one thing to keep in mind is that when we print out the days by default, and you could always go in and specify different formatting and so forth, but by default, it's going to emit it using a standardized output. And you are gonna notice that it will specify April and August more traditionally there. So internally, it's doing it as zero, but when it goes to display it out as part of a string, it is going to display it quote unquote correctly, or at least the way that we as humans would expect it. While I might personally want all counting to start with zero, I'm probably relatively unique in that aspect. As far as setting all the individual values go, you're gonna notice that there's a whole set of different set methods that you can use for the year, the month, the date, the hours, the minutes, and the seconds. Now, the three that I want to call out here real quick, first is month. Again, remember, counting is going to start at zero. The date, that's actually going to set the day. And then again, that hours is going to be the 24-hour clock. So by the time that we're all done here and running this code, it's now going to be April 4th of 2014 at 4 in the morning, and then 24:46. Now you might notice the display there of 11, and the reason for that is because it's doing an offset of UTC on the display. So that's why it's showing us 11 down below there. But at least for my time, which is currently Pacific time, it would wind up being 4 in the morning there. To get our values, you're gonna notice that just like all the set, We have a whole bunch of gets as well. So get month will get us the month. Get day will get us the day, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, where Sunday starts as zero. And then last but not least is get time. Now, one big thing to keep in mind about get time is the fact that it's going to give us back the number of milliseconds since January 1st of 1970. So that could be the potential output if we added in just a little bit of string formatting. And speaking of adding in string formatting and actually running our code and doing all of that, let's go do it. Let's take a look at how we can work with dates inside of JavaScript.